Hi everyone.
Hello.
We are continuing our series on scripture reflections, and today we wanted to prayerfully discuss the account of the martyrdom of John the Baptist from St. Mark's Gospel. So that's Mark chapter 6, 14 to 29. So Mark 6, 14 to 29. And just to kind of briefly go through King Herod, who was the ruler of in the region where Jesus was preaching, had John the Baptist arrested because John the Baptist had preached that Herod should not have married his brother's wife. So Herod was in an unlawful marriage. John the Baptist had told him that. He was arrested, he was imprisoned. And then there's this great line in the passage where it says that Herod was angry at John the Baptist because he had told him that he was in an unlawful marriage. He had kept him in prison. He was perplexed when John the Baptist talked. And then the scriptures say, but Herod liked to listen to him. Perplexed by what he said, but liked to listen to him. And then the rest of the story goes, Herod gave a party for his courtiers and the main nobles of his kingdom. During the party, his stepdaughter, Salome, gave a dance that really he liked, and so he said, I will give you whatever you want, up to half my kingdom. She went and asked her mom, Herodias, who is the wife, the unlawfully married wife. She was really furious with John the Baptist, so she told her daughter, tell him to give you the head of John the Baptist on a platter. So Salome went in and asked Herod to do that. Herod did it, beheaded John, and brought in the head, and then eventually John's disciples came in and took his body and buried it. So it's a powerful story. I mean, there's a lot of things to meditate on, but I think we had talked about that one line, like of all the things, that line about Herod was perplexed by what John said, but liked to listen to him.
Right. Yeah, I mean, first of all, the story has everything. A head on a platter, how often do you have that in scripture? It's a lot going on here. But I just, as Father mentioned, I just love that line that he was perplexed by what he had to say, but he liked to listen to him speak, even though it was upsetting to him, even though he didn't want to hear it because he wanted to keep doing probably what he thought was right, even though now St. John the Baptist is telling him it's wrong. And since we're reflecting on scripture, you know, I think 2020 is a time where there's just, it feels like the world has kind of come to a stop and everyone's disagreeing with each other. And it can be really hard, I can speak for myself, to know how to say what I think is true and not be afraid by someone's reaction to it. And I think all of us, you watching the video too, we have to prayerfully discern what truth is in our lives and how and when we're called to share it. But I can look at a story like this and I can see Jesus throughout his life said things that made people angry. You can look at the Gospels and see that. John the Baptist, as a follower of Jesus, said things that made people angry, but he said them anyway. And there had to be something there in his relationship with God that gave him the courage to do that. And that's kind of what I take out of this scripture, that we can sometimes feel this call to speak out in truth, and it's easier to ignore it. It's more convenient to ignore it. I personally hate conflict. I will try to keep the peace in any situation. But even for me, I'm just feeling more lately that, you know, sometimes you just have to say the truth and trust that maybe people actually will be able to listen to you by the grace of God in that conversation. So it's kind of what I take out of it. What about you, Father?
I think that's profound because, as you said, not just about conflict, that most of us, it's not so much, I mean, some people don't want to get into conflict with other people. But it's just a natural human instinct to want to be liked. And if you say things that are going to be difficult, even if you know they are things that need to be said, you know at least in the short term and possibly in the long term, you may not be liked by that person. And if you look at it from the perspective of John the Baptist, if we put ourselves like in one of the characters in the story and see, so how am I to be like John the Baptist in this, where he knew that Herod was not going to appreciate being told what he needed to hear. And it said it upset Herod, and obviously upset Herod's, you know, new wife. But there was an element, like, Herod liked to listen to him. Was it because he sounded good? Or was it because there really was something in Herod's own heart that he knew that he needed to hear, and probably no one else in his life was saying. He was surrounded by people that would just tell him what he wanted to hear. And Christians, I think, especially us, like you said, in these modern times, and whether it's to the society, probably even more importantly to our own family and friends, we are made for truth. Jesus is the truth. We are made for fulfillment that can be found only in God. And sometimes we may be the only people, if we have that courage, the only people will say that word that may open people's eyes and open people's hearts. Now, in this particular story, it doesn't sound like Herod had a great conversion experience, but he did hear on this occasion, he did hear the word of God that he probably would have not otherwise heard had John the Baptist stayed quiet. And in our own lives, there are probably a lot of people that need to hear a word. It may be difficult, they may not like us for a while, but if we meet them again in heaven, it doesn't matter if they don't like us on earth, you know? And our word, John the Baptist's word, I pray that Herod is with John the Baptist in heaven. And I imagine they probably, if it is the case that they are there, there was probably a strong, socially distant handshake as they entered the eternal kingdom to be able to say, you want to know what? That was part of the reason why I'm here is because you spoke the truth when no one else would. So for us to be able to have that long-term vision of saying, even if it's going to maybe affect a relationship in the short term, you know, I might anger someone or upset someone by saying what needs to be said because I know God is calling me to say this to them in love, to have that long-term vision and say, but if this helps them get closer to Christ, even if I'm no longer a quote-unquote friend of theirs, it's worth it. It's worth it.
Yeah, and it is really hard, you know, as even as we're talking about it, I can think of times where I chose not to speak because I just thought, oh, but I can't lose this relationship. And so I think it is important as you're taking this in and hearing what we have to say to remember that praying about it is really important, not to just go out and start yelling truth at everybody.
Correcting everyone that you see.
Right. It has to be in a relationship or, you know, just asking the Lord to guide you in this. And I think that's a great way to kind of just take little steps, and maybe as it becomes your habit to ask God, well, how can I speak truth into the situation? That can become something that's a little bit more comfortable. So, yeah, those are my thoughts.
Yeah. Hope this helps. Continue praying with the scriptures. It is, just once again, it is Matthew chapter 6, verses 14 to 29. Really let yourself be in the story and pray over, think over these things of my relationship with God so that I'm in relationship to how he preaches to me, right? God and the church, what do they preach to me? Let my heart be formed by that message of salvation, and am I called to spread that to others, even in difficult situations? Mm-hmm. Pray with that, and I guess a final invitation. If you have like meditations that you want us to offer reflections on or scriptures that you like, send in a request to our social media coordinator, and we will go from there. But we hope that this reflection helped, and may God bless you.